Hi, I'm Keith Krieger, Program Director for Computer Applications Training at JCCC. And today we have some tools, tips, and techniques to help you do your work with common computer applications every day. Well, our tips for Word today will cover a couple of tools that will help you be more efficient when you are working with long documents in particular. And here I have a longish document of about 17 pages. And oftentimes I simply want to focus on the document in front of me rather than get distracted by the tools. And the ribbon was brought into Microsoft Office in 2007, and while it's handy, it often gets in the way. It causes us to lose focus. And the easiest way, there's actually two easy ways to get the ribbon out of the way until you need it. Over at the far right-hand end of the toolbar is a upward-pointing caret. And if I hover over it, the tooltip says we can minimize the ribbon. Notice in that tooltip it also gives us a keyboard shortcut to do so. But when I single click that, the ribbon goes out of the way. And the nice thing about this approach is the ability to simply hover and click on a particular tab. The ribbon reappears. I can click the tool I want. And as soon as I click that, the ribbon disappears again. Makes it nice and easy to focus on the work in front of you. The other thing that we have in working with long documents is the ability to split them. So in our example here, we have a cover page on page one, and then we have 16 additional pages. And if I wanted to compare, to copy and paste, without having to move up and down in the document, I can split the document. I can split the view, actually. And if I look at the very top edge of the scroll bar on the right, we see this button labeled View Ruler. And just above it, you'll see a horizontal bar. And you'll notice as I hover over that, I get a double-headed arrow. And I'm going to press and hold and drag that down. We now get two separate windows. Notice over on the right, we have two separate scroll bars. So I can manipulate the document in two different views and move very quickly and easily between the two sections of the document. Now I no longer have to jump back and forth to compare two different sections. I can simply split the view, zoom in and zoom out as need be, and come back to my full document just by double-clicking that bar that we have in the center of the screen. You'll see when I hover over that bar, I double-click it, and I'm returned back to my full page view. Another nice tool, particularly when we're working with long documents and we need to add some content later on, but we want to reserve some space for it, but we don't have the content for it yet. I'm going to move to the very end of the document, and again, instead of picking up the mouse and scrolling, I'm going to use a very quick and easy keyboard shortcut. On the Windows platform, I'm going to hold Control and press the End key. It automatically takes me to the end of the document. I'm going to put this placeholder text on a new page. And instead of pressing Enter multiple times, I'm again going to hold the Control key. And when I press Enter, Word gives me a brand new page. Now this is a really cool tool when I just need some placeholder text. It's going to look like Excel. I'm going to put a equal sign, the word RAND for random, and an open and close paren. I'm going to put two numbers in there, separated by a comma. The first number is the number of paragraphs. The second number is the number of sentences in each paragraph. And when I press Enter, Word enters some pre-built text for me. If you'd prefer not to have English text, you can use a tool that page designers have used for many years in other programs, which is Lorem Ipsum. And it works in much the same way. An equal sign, and lorem, and a pair of parens. And again, the first number for paragraphs, second number is the lines within each paragraph. And now I get a nice set of Greek text that will let me use as a placeholder for future text. We trust you found the tips and tools, techniques in these videos to be helpful in something you can put to use almost immediately. We know that these are things that can be shared easily, and we encourage you to share them with your colleagues and your friends. Post them to Facebook or Twitter or LinkedIn for other people to take advantage of. And if you like, we'd be happy to send you the notes of the tools and techniques that we've shown you here today. Please feel free to send us a message at the address on the screen, and we'll get those right out to you. Thanks.